Well, welcome. Thank you for coming to tonight's event. With this, these types of events come high-running emotions. It gets to the point where you just have to dive right in. You can't cushion things. But having said that, let me talk about who Temple University purpose is. First, give you a little bit of history about who we are, why we are, and where we came from. Last year, the student organization that I was part of, I'm a social work grad student, you know, I assumed that we would be talking about, we would at least be discussing social issues, political issues to improve ourselves as social workers. All we were doing was discussing bake sales, talking about Valentine's Day. I wasn't growing, I wasn't getting the education that I'm paying for. So I decided to branch out and found an organization. What I had in mind with Temple University purpose was to provide an open forum that would be inclusive to the entire student body. For example, on college campuses, as you can hear, students are very passionate about their beliefs. They stand up for things, they fight for things, they believe wholeheartedly in things. But to fight for those things, you should at least know what you're fighting for. If anything, purpose is to inform. Neither are we politically affiliated nor religiously affiliated. All of these organizations and individuals who have accused us of being racist, of being bigots, and the like, no one has ever, to this day, no one has reached out to us. They never asked us, hey, why are you holding these events? Who are you? Who do you think you are? No one. What I'm going to do next, we're going to have our Vice President of Programming, Tyrone, come up, and then I will continue after that. Tyrone Penserga.
Good evening, everyone, and thank you for coming to tonight's event. My name is Tyrone Penserga, and as Alvaro mentioned, I'm one of the officers of TU Purpose's e-board, as well as the presidents of the Asian American Council Act and Temple University's Asian Students Association. I'm grateful for this opportunity tonight to discuss with you, however brief, a couple of things, because it's important not only to know who we are, to finally be able to put some faces to the names, but more importantly, to know exactly what it is that we seek to accomplish. 3 years ago, I was just starting my freshman year of college. And at that time, I was attending a small liberal arts institution in a nearby suburb called Haverford. It was my dream school, complete with nostalgic scenery, as if it were taken straight out of the movie, The Dead Poets Society, with a seemingly impressive student body and faculty. And it was that the institution was, or at least as far as I could tell, unknowingly promoting a culture of hypersensitivity and excessive political correctness. Simply put, they were trying so hard to be colorblind, they were blinding people, completely missing the differences between us that we too should be appreciating. And it wasn't only about the race, but it was also about religion. And it was on this topic that I heard some of the craziest things ever. There are parts of our consciousness that we don't allow to be questioned. We just don't want to talk about it. And if someone comes up to us asking anything even remotely challenging, we've either already demonized them in our minds or have set our brains to let the questions go in one ear and right out the other. You cannot learn one reality and ignore the other, and I highly doubt that I will agree with everything that our speakers will say tonight. But at least I'm inside this room.
Then we go on to bigots. Why are you not hosting a speaker with another point of view? I will answer that with this response from one of the students here. Mr. Spencer writes, not out of an unbiased, disciplined nature, but out of vitriol for the Islamic faith. This is not the etiquette of dialogue. Mr. Spencer, unfortunately, does not want to dialogue, and that is why I have declined Alvaro's invitation, president of the Temple University Muslim Student Association. So, I ask you, what is the etiquette of dialogue? Is the etiquette of dialogue to only engage others who are like-minded and who agree with you? At some point, discussion needs to be had. Another religious club on campus And last year, this particular group invited me to a religious interfaith dialogue of some sort. Gladly I accepted because I thought it would be a wonderful opportunity for me to get to explain and douse rumors that were ignited on campus. I showed up. It was quite confidently, I can say that it was an ambush. There was no dialogue. There was the only aim in that was to attack us and question us, not to engage in dialogue with that. And but you know, I ask, why don't they protest protest against the human rights violations in Iran? Where are the protests against the current practice of stoning persons to death? Where are the persons who protest for the honor killings, against the honor killings that are starting to pop up in America? Where are the protests in support for the Iranian youth and their green movement as they seek a democratic free state? And so I ask, is Temple University purpose really who you should be protesting? And with that, I will welcome Pamela Geller.